morning.
And we are back. I just grabbed some topsoil and threw up on top where I finished off yesterday so I can get this graded in for the final piece of top dressing here. Transition good enough or pretty enough in my eyes, so I'll just do it like I think and then that is what we're going to run with, and when we get some meters backwards then I'll catch up with the lines of the GPS. There's some mistake here in the drawing. I can see it's doing some weird stuff. Men ja, det er jo bare at bakke op til der, hvor doserne holder cirka, så tror jeg, de er klar.
Jamen det var da fantastisk. Jeg var lige lidt forsinket. Jeg havde sgu lige lidt at trække derhjemme. Så er lige væk, hvor der ikke er.
Sådan går det en gang imellem.
Ja, mor her var ikke der 5-6. Hvad laver du? Seriøst? Ja, jeg bor
af. Ja, det går nok. I'll set the camera up outside. that hitch and make that slope, and I have made a design on my own. I'm going to use that as a guidance. Just do this design here on the edge through the GPS, and the rest of it I'll do in freehand. Kind of slope, if I put dirt on where the center section of the bucket is, you know, where that line meets, then I have enough when I tilt the bucket to grade it. Just for a guide and reference when you're building it up, and I just track it in. When you're doing this type of work is a whole lot of patience. Patience, patience, patience. You can't rush this. If you start rushing it, then it will look like the last job I did here. It looked like shit. GPS says 4 or 5 centimeters more, and when I stop, it's just dead on. That's what I mean, I can't trust the GPS. It's not always right. section of this line, it's not something that I need to follow. It's just where this intersection is that I need. Just follow where the grass is and just take the dirt off, and that's it. Just a guiding line, you can put in the height and how big a grade you want to cut on the left or the right side, and you can tilt it if it's going up or down, and you can put in the percentage of the grade that you want to cut. But it's just between, you know, two set points. If you have 2 points, you can make a line, connect through the 2 points, and then you can do whatever you want between those 2 points in a straight line. If you are going up or down or tilt or whatever, you can do all that, but it's just that line you can follow. But when you're doing something like this, you can just make a line through, and then you just put in the grade, and then you have something you can use. It's simple and basic, and it's easy. Sometimes that's what you need. And you can also use that when you're doing, you know, sewer line work or something like that, when you have to follow a straight line from A to B. You can just drive over the line you want, and then mark the A point where you start, and then drive up to the other end where you have your finish point, the point B, and then mark that, and then the machine will draw a line from A to B. It's pretty simple and pretty neat. And it's, you know, it's the basics. And the new computer systems that we have today, you can put in several A, B, C, D, you know, lines and connect them. You can do circles or whatever you want. But this system that I have on here is 5 years old now, and it's outdated. But it works, and it's too expensive to just, you know, buy the new stuff. I'll be back when I'm done for today. So this is how it looks from this corner, and this is what I have done now in the garden, and then I gotta come up with a plan to finish up the top, and that will be continued on Thursday, I think, because tomorrow I have some family business I need to attend to, so I'm off work. But I'll see you Thursday.